Hey everyone, today I'm going to discuss with you a very important topic that obviously is also very confusing for you people, that is how to learn symbols of different elements. And for knowing that, first you should be knowing what actually are the elements and what gives a particular element a particular characteristic symbol. So element is basically one such substance which has its own characteristic property. And each element has its own characteristics property which are totally different from the other elements. Each element has its own symbol which is used to represent that particular element. Why actually we opt for symbols? Because it is convenient for us to write. Like if you want to write hydrogen, then you have to write these many alphabets. But if you have to just represent it symbolically, then you will be mentioning it as H. Quite easy. Again, if you have to write nitrogen, then you have to write so many alphabets for just denoting nitrogen. But if you're writing in this manner, quite easy. So basically, the purpose of writing symbols of elements is to just make it convenient for us to write. Because when we are writing chemical equation, then it will become very tedious job to write all these long alphabetical terms. Instead of that, it is far easy to just denote with these single alphabets. Okay, somewhere these are single alphabets, somewhere like in case of magnesium, there are two alphabets you have to learn. So I'll explain you how it is easy for you to learn. For this earlier, there was a method which was designed by Dalton. Dalton was a person who initially gave a pictorial representation. Pictorial means you have to draw certain pictures which will help in just representing the particular element. Like if you have to write hydrogen, then you will be just drawing a circle, having a dot in between. Somewhere you have to draw a circle and then you have to draw a cross. Somewhere you have to draw a circle and then draw a line in between. These were the ways by which Dalton helped us to represent a particular element. But again, that was a very tedious job. So instead of that, we should be having some method which will be easy and convenient for everyone to keep in mind. For this, there was a method which was derived by another well-known scientist. He was Berzelius. Now, Berzelius was a scientist who actually worked on this part of the chemistry, that how it can be made easy for everyone to learn about elements. And then he gave the symbols. So how he gave the symbols? For that you need to learn about certain elements, and there are some common elements, so those are required to be learned. So let us begin. If I am writing hydrogen, this is the first element of your periodic table. We have total 118 elements which are found till date, and out of those 118, the first one is hydrogen. Second is helium, then lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon. I've just written first six. I'll explain you all later. Now, hydrogen is what Berzelius said, that it is easy for us to denote a particular element with the first letter from where it begins. So, what he told that we should be writing hydrogen as H. He said we should be using the first letter, and first letter should also be written as capital letter. But if there is an element which is having the same beginning of the alphabet, means hydrogen also begins with H and helium also begins with H, then it will become quite obvious that we have to opt for something else. Now then what we can do is, he suggested that we should be opting for the first letter capital and the second adjacent letter, and it should be written in small letters. Now this is the symbol of helium. This way we have to learn all the symbols: lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon. These are the first six elements which I have written, and these are their symbols. Now, these are the common symbols. You can easily learn these because these are the initial elements, and most commonly we are using hydrogen, very commonly used, and carbon, very commonly used element. Then I will be telling you about 20 main elements, 1 to 20, and what are their symbols. I will draw a table for that. It will be easy for you to understand. These are the first 20 elements I have written. I am writing their symbol. Hydrogen is denoted by H, helium He, lithium Li, beryllium Be, boron B, carbon C, nitrogen N. These are the first seven elements I have written. Then oxygen by O, then fluorine by F, then neon Ne, then sodium Na. And why we are writing Na for sodium? Because actually it has come from a Latin word which is called as natrium. So the first two alphabets of this natrium are used. Then magnesium, then aluminium, then silicon. Then phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium. Potassium is denoted by K. Again, why it is by K? Because potassium is actually derived from the Latin word kalium, and the first alphabet of kalium. Then calcium is by Ca. So these are the first 20 elements which you are supposed to learn, and these are very commonly and frequently used in our periodic table. So hope now it is clear to you. But there are certain anomalies, like natrium is an anomaly, because you might be confused with sodium. You might be thinking that it should come as S. No, its symbol is Na, and it is derived from Latin word natrium. And potassium, again, it is denoted by K because it is derived from the Latin word kalium. There are eight more such elements which are derived from the Latin words. Let me tell you which are these. These are the 10 elements I have written here, and these are basically anomalies that you will be confused, that their name is different but their symbol does not match with their name. So here I will tell you what actually is the reason for that particular symbol of that element. Like first one I have written here is sodium. Sodium is derived from the Latin word natrium, so its symbol is Na. Then potassium, Latin word kalium, and its symbol is K. Copper, the Latin word cuprum. So this is the reason we write it as Cu, because when you are writing it as Co, then it comes out to be cobalt. That will be a totally different element. So this is Cu. Iron, derived from ferrum, and its symbol is Fe. Lead, derived from plumbum, and this is the reason its symbol is Pb. Then mercury, its Latin name is hydrogenium, so we write its symbol as Hg. Then tin, its Latin term is stellum, so we write it as Sn. Then silver. Silver is derived from Latin word argentum, and it has the symbol Ag. Gold, it is derived from the Latin word aurum, so it is written as Au. And then antimony at last is derived from Latin word stibnum, and its symbol is Sb. So these are the anomalies which are because of the Latin word from where these are derived, and this is the reason their symbol is not matching with the English name of these elements. Now hope it is clear to you, and you will not be confused now why actually we are using these. Hope you people people are able to learn all these, actually you have to memorize a few very commonly used elements, then only it will be easy for you. You need not to get confused that every time you have to learn all these elements. With the passage of time, when you keep on going through the same elements, it will be automatically fixed in your mind. So don't panic while learning. It will be a natural process that it will stuck in your mind somehow when you keep on going through the same topic again and again.